Hi everyone. So in this video, we will talk about Docker image and Docker containers. We'll just play around with the different images and different containers. And we will see how the images are being converted into the containers and how the containers are being started, stopped, or destroyed. Okay. So once we have a Docker file or Docker image, we actually runs that. Docker file, for that Docker file we have to build it, so it will become image, and then we run the image, so it will become container. Okay, if you already have a Docker image like Redis, Ubuntu, or MongoDB, MySQL, you run that image, it will become container. When you destroy that container, image will still be there. Okay, because image is actually a persisted container image. It's a static image which is occupied on a particular volume. Okay, these are the registry. Okay, registry stores many static image. What we do is we run pull command. We are actually downloading these images on our system. Then we are running the image. It will give us a particular container on our system, right? So what is these registry? So all these, like, there is AWS container registry, Google Cloud registry. So all these vendors have their own private registries also, which we can consume. They are providing as a service. So like if I wanted to have my own container images to be pushed, not as a public, as a private, and I'm using AWS as a cloud, then I can have an AWS container registry. I can register my image and all my project will use that specific image only, because it may have some security stuff already added in that particular image which I'm using. Okay, so what is this image to container transition? Container is an instance of image, which we already know. So whenever you run basic commands like Docker pull, if you just see Docker pull Ubuntu, what it is going to do is it is just checking that Ubuntu image is available locally. If image is already there, right, you can see image is up to date and it is the latest, right? I didn't specify any version, I didn't specify any tag, so it is actually pulling the latest and it is already available. So if you just do Docker pull Redis, it is also available. So we can just say Docker images to know what all images we already have. We can see Ubuntu, Redis, Node.js. So we can just say Node Carbon. Let's see if there is a particular image with the tag name as a Node Carbon. Okay, it is also available. So we have all these set of images available. Now how we are actually converting these images into a container? So if you wanted to see how many container I have, nothing. Docker ps minus a, all active containers. Okay, I have some dead containers which I can just remove. Docker rm, because these containers are already stopped. So we should be able to get rid of all the dead containers which are already exited. Everything is clean, right? Now what I do is I actually try to run a Ubuntu image. So when I just do Docker run Ubuntu, what will happen is it actually try to run the Ubuntu image, but there is no process running, so it will exit the container. Now if you see, you can see Docker container, it actually started and it actually stopped. Nothing happens, right? So to start an image, we have to do something there so that we can see the container is living, some processes keeps running. So what we can do is we can run this particular command, Docker run in the interactive mode Ubuntu image and open bin bash terminal. Okay, now I am inside the container which we were talking about, mini Linux, right? So this is the container I have, and I can actually execute basic commands which are not there. Or okay, it is actually basic commands, like I can access v-editor. So it is actually mini Linux container I have while just doing Docker pull Ubuntu and I'm running it. It is actually minimal. It doesn't have all the utility applications which you need. So Docker run minus it, what it is doing is, now if you just see in another terminal, if you try to see how many containers you have running, So you will see one running about a minute. This is exited and this is still up and running, right? So we can just remove this particular dead container. Now we can see only this is up and running, okay? And we can also do a lot of things like inspect this particular container. It will give us the more details about the container, like the configuration, network configuration, volume configurations and all, if it is occupying. So that will come later, okay? So coming back to our first tab, so here we are able to access things and we will just exit it because now our task is done. So the difference is we pull the image, it will not become container. We have to run it and run it with some process so that we can access it. Okay, docker run minus it redis, and I can also access. So bin bash is actually some common process which exists in all containers. You can access any of the application, and it has actually redis installed. Now it is running the redis, right? So I am not sure if redis CLI will be there. You can see redis CLI is there, and I'm trying to connect. So it's a redis container, and with the help of redis CLI I'm just trying to connect to this particular container. Okay, so I'm exiting from the container. So this is how we are actually creating containers and destroying them. Now you can see both are exited because we have exited this bin bash process. Now we can just say docker container prune if you want to clean out all the containers which are dead. We have everything is empty, right? Similarly, docker volume prune, image prune commands are there. Once you are done, you can just clean up the resources, otherwise it will unnecessarily occupy the space. Okay, so in this video we just talked about how we are creating containers from the image. We will also see how we are creating the image from the build file, docker build file. Then once the image is there, how to run that and create container out of it.